How's my quad squad doing? It's the man, the myth, the legend, Quad MFT here. Today is everybody's favorite hump day, Wisdom Wednesday. We're here with a new setup. What's going on, Quad Father?
Hey, what is up, Warriors? It's the Quad Father here. And we have some interesting stories today, and I think we should get right to them.
People send in questions, and before I actually go throughout and answer these questions, we want to tell them that even them,
You too.
Send in questions.
You too.
Don't comment them. I mean, if you want to, but just inbox me on YouTube. That's the only way I really get questions, so you guys can go ahead and do that.
And that way I can make up names for you.
Yeah, and if you guys actually want help, kind of the reason why we do this whole situation. But all right, let's start off with the first question. This one says, hey, Quad, a school banquet is coming up soon, and I want to ask this girl out. And we've been friends for a couple of years, and she's always talking about other guys.
Okay.
All right.
It's not looking good so far.
It's hard to ask her out if I don't know if she likes me, so I should ask her out. So should I ask her out? And if so, what is the best way to do it? There's another question just like this one. Okay. Literally, I mean, they just ask if they should ask her out because they've been friends for a while and stuff like that. But this guy says that, you know,
she
talks about other guys.
Two words. Move on.
I mean, if you haven't
given
any effort,
there's so many girls out there.
We don't know if he's ever given any effort. I mean, if he's in the situation where he's kind of came onto her and said, you know, he kind of likes her and she kind of knows that, then I'd say move on. Yeah, and you know, oh, but I don't want to risk our friendship.
Risk the friendship. How many girls do you want as friends really anyway?
A few.
How many guy friends do you want? You know, I mean, that's
the majority.
Yeah, a lot more. So how much time do you want to spend chasing after a girl that obviously likes other guys? I mean, let's say she does like
him. We're just trying to help a brother out.
Right. Let's say she does like him. What's she doing running around with all these other guys?
Not much.
Yeah, clearly, not waiting around for him.
Yeah, she's not been waiting, you know, kind of pestering you. Trust me. Move on from the situation.
Sometimes
if it's how you described
This is just tough love, man.
We're just trying to help a brother
out.
Just
telling you the way we see it.
Just trying to help a quad squad member out. You ready for the next question?
All right, let's go on to number two.
That one. I hope that helped a lot of people understand. Yeah. But yeah, let's hear the second question here.
This is
right.
I got screen rotation.
Yeah, all right. Hey, Quad and Quad Father, I'm 17 and I have had a harder time at life in high school than most, basically. Okay. I've been used by this girl. She took from me 30 pounds, which I imagine was $45 in the space of 2 weeks, and I didn't know what to, and I didn't want to know me after, and to oh, and didn't want to know me after, and to make matters worse,
she then went
and had sex with a guy who we really can't stand each other. And it feels like he's got one over me.
I have
a couple of friends. The only time I've really happy is when I've played video games online with my friends. But I want to get out there and meet more and new people and try to lift myself from feeling depressed.
Okay, so he's feeling down, and this girl
did him
wrong.
Oh, very wrong. As he said, I feel so lonely all the time, and I want to know if you have any advice for me. I have also a heart defect, so I can't do sports, which sucks because I'm a big soccer fan. Football for you people that aren't in, I want to say not just America. I want to say
it's American football.
No,
but other countries.
You guys know what I'm saying. Yeah. But I mean, like Canada. They call it football, soccer too, but you know,
Canadian football,
whatever you say. All right, I'm a big soccer fan, but basically, how do I stop feeling depressed, and how do I meet new people my own age? I don't care too much about a girlfriend. I just want some friends who are supportive and would like me for me. Thanks for any help. A reply will do, but Wisdom Wednesday would mean the world from a loyal sub.
There you go.
Wisdom Wednesday would mean the world. So,
all right.
I guess
are the world. Thanks for writing in, Damien.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Sounds like, I mean, I don't think he has any interest in the girl he mentioned, right? I mean, he just is saying this is what got him down.
Yeah, that's the thing that spiraled him
into
the situation that he's in now.
All right. And now he feels like he doesn't have a lot of friends that are close to him.
Yeah, not really.
Okay. So, I mean, to me, it's the find things that you love. Go join a club of some kind. There's lots of things that aren't sports.
On their own time, you know,
right. And we love hanging out with you.
There's people at your school. Trust me.
Yep.
I know this. There's people at your school that also enjoy video games.
Almost everybody.
You know, you may not know that they enjoy video games. You know, I've been in multiple situations where I found out that people play video games that I didn't know played video games.
Even if you just wear a shirt like this. Like, if you saw someone walking around with this shirt.
I wouldn't go and talk to them just because.
You would never see, even if you pass them, like, hey, nice shirt.
No.
Really?
Yeah.
I do that in public.
That's not the way high school works. No.
I do that in public with people.
Yeah, I do.
You know,
but not at
like in the mall. If I saw someone with MW3, I'm like, dude, that was a good one. That's my second favorite or something.
School's crazy. School's different
because kids are jerks.
Yeah, but it's just different.
They're not open. How different? No. Then tell me how different.
Nobody's open. Everybody tries to be the same robot.
So everybody's just like straightforward, not joking around?
No.
Unless they're with a friend?
I'm saying they try to be the robot that is the regular kid in society.
So they try to be part of the group. Not necessarily. But then there are kids who actually go crazy off the other side where they're so unconventional. Everybody's like, whoa, you got a lot of style.
Let's get back on track here. There are people there that enjoy video games, that enjoy talking about soccer, if you may. And that's the people that you got to find. How can you find them?
He sounds like he's from Europe or Britain or something.
Yeah,
right.
With the pounds.
So, I think it's all individual, down to your school. I mean, because you're not really going to find them online unless you started a high school Facebook page of your interest.
That's not going to work very well at all.
Like, no,
don't,
it would.
Don't take that advice.
I'm just saying every place is different, and how you reach people is totally different. Here's what I say. Take the risk like you were talking about. Put yourself out there with what you're interested in.
Ask them, like, do you play Xbox, PS, or anything? And they say, Call of Duty.
I do that all the time.
Yeah, it's an easy thing to bring up with any guy. With people that don't play video games, they know what Call of Duty is. They know that kids play Xbox.
Right.
You know, bring it up to them. And if they say no, you can still be friends with them.
Oh, no, those kids are geeks or whatever.
No one says that. Very few people say.
Like,
I've never met someone who says, like, I'm a Call of Duty commentator. I have 30,000 subs on YouTube, or almost, wink, wink.
Real close.
But
subscribe now.
No one says, like, I hate that, man. I hate Call of Duty. Freaking nerd. No one says that.
Right.
Very few, at least.
To your face.
Yeah.
They text me.
Yeah, yeah.
And they say it about them all the time.
So that's how you got to do it, man. Just talk to the people individually. You ready?
One last one.
Here's the last one. All right. Hey, Quad and Quad Father. First off, I love all your videos. Here's my question.
It's nice to hear. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
We love you back.
Lately, it seems like everything I do goes badly. I don't have any trouble with girls, actually. The way I see it, if a girl talks to me, they like me. But
my confident man.
But my real problem is that anytime I do something that everyone else does, people give me crap about it. For instance, I was going to a football game and everyone said that I should have not been smoking pot on the airplane the way I figured it. If I chartered the plane, I can do what I want. Another time, I was just driving around the streets, and I have a friend block off the intersection so we could race and not hurt anybody.
This guy sounds like he's living on the edge, man.
But everybody made a big deal about it. Here's my problem now. I was just at the batting cages, and there was this girl taking pictures of me, and I asked her to stop because the flash was really distracting me, and now she is saying that I assaulted her.
Wow.
Quad, can you help me? I need to know how to get rid of all this negative attention. Thanks in advance. By the way, you can call me Justin.
Huh. Well, it sounds like the young man's in quite a different situation.
The young man, Justin, is in a deep situation right now.
Well, I think probably what it is he's getting bad advice.
Yeah.
There are people around him who won't tell him no. They won't keep him out of trouble.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's hard because he's 18 or 19 now, I think. 19 who? Years old. Justin.
He didn't say his age.
Justin, 19 years.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So he's 19 years old. Okay.
But and think about that.
Yeah, and so he's doing stuff that it's on the edge. I mean, who charters a jet to go to the Super Bowl?
Yeah.
You know, but I guess.
Why wouldn't you?
Well, if you could, you would.
Yeah. If we could, we would.
Right. And so, he's getting the pilot's eye. Apparently, it's not really a good thing.
Yeah.
So that's on the edge.
Help him relax,
I don't want my pilot
want
smoke a pot.
Pilot?
For the record. I want a pilot who's completely sober. Okay. You could fly in whatever planes you want.
I'll take the high.
Apparently.
Yeah.
Okay. And then what was the third thing he did? He was just, he blocked off the streets. Oh,
no,
that's another
one. That was
one.
The second one. He blocked off the streets to street race. Justin. What are you doing?
No, that's
fun.
Okay. Why? Now it's good. Okay. Got to give you a little bit of help or tip of the cap to the fact that you actually blocked off the streets. Most kids just drive fast.
You just go.
You
looked out for others.
And the whole batting cages thing.
I don't know what's going on with that girl.
Don't beat up girls.
Yeah, no, that's a terrible decision.
Matter of fact,
delusional.
Say that goes for everyone.
Yeah.
Don't hit a girl. First of all, what did I always tell you about fighting a girl? Don't fight a girl because...
So if you win, you beat a girl? Like,
that's
Who cares? You freaking beat a girl.
Right. And if you lose, you lost to a girl. Now, that aside, that's just a saying... Don't fight with girls. Don't hit girls. Okay.
I mean,
that's
spare
not cool.
them. They're not as great.
They're
as
genteel.
Us. Even though I actually have a decent amount of girl viewers, like, to be honest.
Yeah.
Hey, oh. Shout out, 530.
You sound like just like this Justin character. If they talk to me, they like me. Is that how you believe?
I don't know. I'm a very confident guy. No, all right. I'm just saying that. But I hope you guys enjoyed.
I don't think the chicks dig that.
Yeah, probably not. No. Kind of sounds very cocky, and it is very cocky. But hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe now and join the hashtag Quad Squad. Closing in on 30,000 subscribers. Check out all my social media links down in the description below. Check out his Twitter, too. He's a funny guy. I hope you guys enjoyed. It's been Quad MFT, and I'm outie.
And I'll see you at the batting cages.